Hello everyone, welcome to CADCAM-C Tutorials. In this video, we are going to design a helical bevel pinion that you can see on the screen right now. So let us first close it and we'll go for a new part and uncheck here use default templates and OK. And here we'll select solid part millimeter kg second and OK. Now first we'll make all the planes visible, then we'll go for sketch and select here this right plane. Sketch and we'll go for sketch view. Now first we'll insert a horizontal center line over here, then we'll go for line and we'll draw one random sketch over here like this. Now we'll apply the different dimensions. Now here this horizontal line is of 5 mm, this horizontal line is of 46 mm, and this horizontal line is of 10 mm. Now we'll apply dimensions for vertical line. So this vertical line is of 1 mm, and here this vertical line is of 6 mm, and this vertical line is of 45 mm. Then we'll go for 3-point arc and we'll draw an arc over here like this, and radius of this arc is 11 mm. Then again we'll go for line and we'll complete the sketch like this. Then we'll go for dimensions, select here this end point and this corner point and press here scroll button and enter distance is 102 mm. Now this sketch is completed, so we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for revolve and then click on OK. Now we'll go for plane and we'll make plane from this face and enter distance is 32 mm and OK. Then we'll go for sketch and select here this plane, sketch and sketch view. Now here first we'll draw one circle like this, and diameter of circle is 76 mm. Then we'll go for line and we'll insert a horizontal line like this. Now length of this line is 10 mm, and this is the half length, that is 5 mm. Now distance of this line from the center line, that is 43 mm. Then again we'll go for line and we'll draw two vertical line from the endpoints. Now we'll go for delete segment and we'll delete these segments. So here the sketch is closed one and we'll exit the sketch and we'll go for extrude. And the distance is 48 mm, enter here 48, and here we have to reverse the direction, so reverse direction and OK. Now we have to make 15 such pattern, so select here this extrude, go for pattern. Now we'll select here axis because we want circular pattern, and then we'll select here this center line. Now we have to make 15 such pattern, so enter here 15 and select here this angle button and OK. Now we have to make teeth profile, and for that we'll go for plane, select here this plane and give distance as 45 mm. OK, again we'll go for plane and select here this new plane and give distance as 50 mm. Now we'll go for sketch and select here this first plane and we'll go for sketch and sketch view. Now here first we'll draw one circle with a diameter of 100 mm. Now we have to draw two horizontal lines, and for that we'll go for line and draw one line like this, and draw another line like this. Now length of this line is 15 mm, so enter here 15, and this is half of that, that is 7.5 mm. Now we have to give the distance between this horizontal line and the center line, and the distance is 85 mm. Now length of this line is 40 mm, and make sure that this line is horizontal one. Now we'll go for 3-point arc and select this end point, and draw an arc like this, and radius of this arc is 65 mm. Now we have to draw same arc on this side also, and radius is 65. Now after making one teeth, we have to make 6 such teeth, and for that first we'll go for center line. And we'll insert one horizontal center line like this. Then we'll select here this teeth. Then we'll go for mirror and select here this center line. Now again we'll go for center line and we'll insert one center line over here like this. Now the angle between this center line and this vertical center line, that is 30 degrees. Now again we'll select both these tooth and we'll go for mirror and select here the center line. Now again we'll go for center line and we'll draw one center line like this, and give angle, this angle is 60 degrees and this angle is 30 degrees, so enter here 60. Now again we'll select both this sketch. Then we'll go for mirror and select this center line. Now we have made 6 teeth, and now we'll delete unwanted portions. So we'll go for delete segment, and we'll delete these segments, these unwanted profiles. Now the sketch is completed. Now we have to copy this sketch. So select here entire sketch, and then press Ctrl C for copy, and we'll exit the sketch. Now we'll go for sketch and select here the second plane sketch and go for sketch view. Now here right click and select here paste, and select anywhere over here. Now the scaling factor is 0.75 and degree of rotation is 15 degrees. Now drag this sketch over here like this, and then click on OK, and we'll exit the sketch. Now we have to draw a third sketch over here, so we'll go for sketch, select here this plane and sketch, and we'll go for sketch view, right click over here and select here paste, and click anywhere over here. Now in this case the scaling factor is 0.5 and the angle of rotation is 30 degrees, and now we have to drag this sketch over here like this, and then click on OK, and we'll exit the sketch. Now we'll make all the planes and axes hide. Now we'll go for shapes and select here blend. Now select here selected sections, then we'll go for sections. Now first we'll select this bigger section, so we have to select any point over this curve, so we'll select this point. Now again we'll go for insert, and now we have to select corresponding point on this profile, so it will be over here like this, so select here this corner point. Now again we'll go for insert, and we have to select corner point on this profile, so the corresponding corner point will be this point. So select here this point and then click on OK. Now we'll make all the sketches hide. So select here all these three sketches, right click and select here hide. Now we'll give it appearance So we'll go for view, appearances, and we'll select here polystyle, then select here entire part and okay. Now we'll go for applications, render studio. Now here we'll go for real-time settings and here we'll select performance mode and select here global illumination and okay. Then we'll go for scenes, edit scene and select here background, and in background we want to give plain color, so select here color and here you can select white color and okay. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, then please hit on the like button, share it and subscribe to this channel, CAD CAM CE Tutorials. Thanks.